Hello everybody, today we are going to discuss how to draft an invitation. So in CBSE class 12th English paper, your fourth question is invitation along with the other options, other questions such as notice writing, poster and advertisement. So this question will be of 4 marks, and so first of all we must know how these 4 marks are divided. So let's see and begin with that. Invitation. Four marks, and here we discuss allocation of marks. First, layout. Content, expression. One mark. One and a half marks. One and half marks. So you can see the layout is of 1 mark, content is of 1.5 marks, and expression is of 1.5 marks. So it means for that box and RSVP you are given 1 mark, for content you are given 1.5 marks. So content is your subject matter. It means the answer of how, when, what, where, all these things must be included. An expression means coherence, relevance, fluency, style, grammar and spelling. So if you write all these things properly, if all these things are in proper order and without any mistake, you get 1.5 marks for expression as well. Now let's see the format, that what is the proper format of drafting an invitation. So first of all, we write the name of the host, name of the host. After this, we use formal language of invitation, as do we find in the invitations that we generally have at our homes, that solicit your benign presence or request your benign presence. So such kind of formal language should be used after the name of the host. After this formal language, we write the occasion. So whatever is the occasion, whether wedding ceremony, whether birthday, whether tonsure ceremony, inauguration, whatever is the occasion, that should be mentioned after this. If name is to be given, because in weddings we give the name of the bride and bridegroom, so that can be included. If it is birthday party, in that case also we give the name of the birthday boy or birthday girl, so that should be given, right? After the occasion, we must mention the date, venue and time. So when you complete all these things, then left hand side you should write RSVP, and after RSVP, name of host and address of host should be given. Under RSVP, you should write the name of host and address of host. Now, what does this RSVP mean? This RSVP is reply if you please. So actually the purpose is that if you are unable to attend the party or the function or the ceremony, then it's okay, no problem. You can send your wishes or greetings or even gifts to this address. Okay. So this is the purpose of writing RSVP. The meaning is reply if you please. The full form is different because it's not in English. It is respond as silver's plate. Respond as silver's plate. This is the full form and the meaning is reply if you please. So just for the sake of information, otherwise we don't need the full form, we don't need to write the full form. And here in the right hand side we write with best wishes or with best compliments, that can be written. Below this we write near and dear, or we can also write friends and relatives. So whatever you like to write, either of the two can be mentioned, either of the two can be written. So this is the proper format, and along with this you must keep in your mind that it should be centrally aligned. This is quite important in invitation. It should be centrally aligned, otherwise it won't look proper and definitely you won't get full marks here. No third person pronoun. You must remember this thing. You should not use, only third person. Only third person is used. We don't use first person or second person. Only third person should be used. And no abbreviation. No abbreviation for day and month. That means for Saturday you can't write Sat, for Monday you can't write MON, for November you can't write NOV, for January you can't write Jan. So this kind of abbreviations for days and months should be avoided. We don't follow this practice in invitation. So these are the points that you should keep in your mind, because this is the general mistake that most of the students commit, that they use first person or second person pronoun and they forget to put it in a box. They don't write RSVP or these things, the name of the host and address of the host below this. So, and moreover, they don't centrally align the invitation. So these are the common mistakes that the students generally commit, and you can also, so that's why I'm telling you all this in the beginning, that you should avoid all these mistakes. Now let's take an example of invitation, that what should be a complete, a perfect invitation. So first we'll write Mrs. and Mr. so and so, then solicit your benign prisons, this should be written. You can use this language or you can use any other language. For example, instead of solicit your benign prisons, you can write request the pleasure of your gracious company, or request the pleasure of your gracious request the pleasure of your gracious presence. So this language can also be used, or you may draft your own line which can be properly placed here. After this, you must write about the occasion. On the auspicious occasion of. Now, what is the occasion that must come at the center? For example, wedding ceremony. Wedding ceremony. So this can be written in the center like this. You can capitalize the complete thing, or you can capitalize just the first word, first letter of each word. That can be done. After this, of their daughter or son, as per the question, whatever is given in the question, as per that, of their daughter or of their son. So I pointed out earlier that don't use first person or second person pronoun. It means it shouldn't be like of my daughter or of your daughter. Such kind of words should be avoided. Only third person can be used. Now, the name of the daughter or the son can be given here. Below this, below the name, you can put in brackets the name of grandparents. That can be done. And next, it should be bit slanting manner. You should write weds or with, as you see in the invitation cards. After this, again the name. So the names of both bride and bridegroom should be written here. And below the names, you can write, as I said, the name of the grandparents. So here the name of the grandparents can be written, because the name of the parents have already been mentioned above. And here the name of the parents can be written, because first parents are there and then the grandparents. So here we don't have to mention the name of the grandparents, right? After this, you must write about the venue, time and date. So let me rub this. So when you complete all this description, you can write on Sunday December 8 at 8 Maheshwari Resort. And now the time, from 6 PM onwards. So this is complete language, and now here we'll write RSVP, then the name and the address, and here we'll write with best wishes. And below this, near and dear. And the whole thing must be put in a box. So only by writing this much you can get 4 out of 4 marks. You don't have to write say all the details as you find in the card that you receive in local language or Hindi or other such language, because there are loads of other things. All the rituals are given in such cards, like haldi and all, basan and such kind of things. So you don't have to mention all those details here. That can be avoided. This is the simplest method, the simple way, and the perfect way of scoring 4 out of 4 in formal invitations. Now there are formal replies as well. So how to write a reply for this kind of invitation? That is also very much simple. Let's see that. So now formal replies. Let me explain this through an example. This should also be in a box, and it must be Mr. So and So is much pleased to receive the invitation of Mrs. and Mr. So and So. Now here you must write the occasion. So occasion must be given. Is much pleased to receive the invitation of Mrs. and Mr. to whatever, like wedding ceremony or inauguration, housewarming. So that occasion must be there. On date. Date must be there. And after this, what are you going to do? Whether you will attend the function or you won't be able to attend the function, accordingly you must write a language. For example, but he regrets his inability to attend the same. So here we have written that he is unable to attend, and so request his inability to attend the same is given. And this is the complete language. After this, in the end, you can write regards or you can write thanks. So with that expression, you can close the box and you will be given 4 marks for drafting this formal invitation. So as simple as that. There is no problem at all. Just one thing, one pattern you have to learn, and that is what you have to copy out in your answer sheet. Okay. And you have informal invitations as well. Now, how do we draft an informal invitation? That too is quite simple. Just as we write a letter, In that form only we draft an informal invitation. So what is the format and how do we write? Let's see an example of informal invitation as well. Informal invitation. So in informal invitation, as I said, we write like letter. So first we write the sender's address. Then we write the date. Then we write the salutation. And after salutation, body. So what do we write in body? It can be like, you'll be quite happy to know, or I'm glad to inform you, or I'm quite pleased to inform you. It gives me immense pleasure to invite you to the occasion. So this is what we include in the body. And this must be in an informal language. We don't need any formal language here. And moreover, no third person here, because this is, as I said, an informal invitation. So in informal invitations, we don't need to use third persons. You can directly address the person to whom you are writing. So it can be you and I. This kind of expressions can be used. So in the body, mention all the details like venue, date, occasion. All these things are to be mentioned. And finally, the subscription. So, before subscription, you can write that I hope you will grace the occasion with your presence. This kind of expressions can be used at the end of the informal invitation. That I hope you will definitely come along with your family, your wife and children. So this kind of expression at the end of the informal invitation can be used. And then use ever, yours, loving, your affectionately. So this kind of expressions for subscription, leave taking expression can be used. So this is the pattern of informal invitation. So I hope you understood. This is quite easy to score 4 marks. So don't commit any silly mistake. Be quite careful and read the question properly. Accordingly, you must answer involving all the details given in the question. Thank you very much for watching.